Hello, in this video, we are going to give an introduction to Java programming language. Java is a simple and powerful, high-level, object-oriented programming language. It originated at Sun Microsystems in 1991. It was conceived by James Gosling and was initially called Oak. The latest version of Java is 13, which was released in September 2019 by Oracle, who brought over Sun Microsystems. Java was developed to provide a platform-independent programming language. Here, platform-independent means that the Java was designed with the concept of write once and run everywhere. Unlike many other programming languages, including C, C++, where after compilation, machine code is generated, in Java, source code is compiled into platform-independent bytecode. This bytecode is distributed over the web and interpreted by Java Virtual Machine or JVM on whichever platform it is being run. Here, Java bytecode is a byte-long instruction that Java compiler generates and stores in a .class file. It's called bytecode as each instruction in the code is 1 byte long and can have one or more bytes of operands. This bytecode is not specific to any platform and can be inserted in HTML and distributed over the internet. JVM is the engine which converts Java bytecode to machine language. It is part of JRE or Java Runtime Environment in which Java program executes. It is an interpreter. The JVM or JRE must be implemented on a particular platform before compiled programs can run on that platform. A JVM can either interpret the bytecode one instruction at a time, or the bytecode can be compiled further for the real machine code using what is called a just-in-time compiler. Note that Java program requires both a compiler and then interpreter. First, compiler to generate bytecode and then interpreter to convert to machine code. As bytecode could run on any machine which had JVM, this made Java program highly portable. To write Java programs, we use JDK or Java Development Kit. JDK is nothing but a complete development package which contains a private Java Virtual Machine or JVM and a few other resources such as interpreter, loader, a compiler, an archiver, a document generator, etc. to complete the development of a Java application. To start writing code, you can install the latest version of JDK from Oracle site. Choose your platform and download the installer. It will install all the components for you. Most programmers also opt to have an IDE or integrated development environment to improve productivity. IDE provides a rich graphical user interface-based workbench designed to aid a developer. It has a built-in editor and interactive interface to create and test objects. It also has debugger, help, etc. integrated with the IDE. Popular IDEs are Applets, BlueJ, NetBeans, etc. We are going to use BlueJ for our programs as it is free and simple IDE developed specifically for educational purposes. It was developed in 1991 by Michel Colling at Monash University and now is being supported and maintained by University of Kent. You can Google on BlueJ and download it from BlueJ site. Download the file for your platform and use default settings to install. We are not covering the installation and tutorial of BlueJ here. When we start writing Java programs, they are of two types, application program and applets. Application program are standalone programs that are written to carry out certain tasks on local computer, such as solving equations, reading and writing files, etc. The application program can be executed using two steps, First, compile source code to generate bytecode using Java compiler. Execute the bytecode program using Java interpreter. Example of application program include servlets, which are programs which run on the web server to generate dynamic content. Applets are small Java programs developed for internet applications. They can be included in HTML document. An applet located in distant computer can be downloaded via internet and executed on a local computer using Java capable browser. The Java applets can also be executed in the command line using Applet Viewer, which is part of the JDK. When we write Java programs, we could encounter three types of errors: syntax errors, logical errors, and runtime errors. Syntax errors are errors occurring when you violate a syntax rule. They are caught during compile time. Example: forgetting to terminate a program with a semicolon. Then there are logical errors, also called as design errors, or bugs which escape compilation. It occurs when logic of the program is incorrect, so your program compiles and runs but gives incorrect output. It can be fixed by testing and debugging the program. Example: specifying wrong value of pi. Next, there are runtime errors. They occur when we ask the computer to do something it considers to be illegal. In these cases, Java throws exception and the program stops midway. Example: dividing by zero, where Java interpreter doesn't know what to do. In our next video, we will learn more about object-oriented concepts in Java.